We're here at East Coast Gear Supply. Me and Chase have been talking axles all day today. And now we're talking about, this is my also my favorite axle. I love 14 volts.
Yeah.
It's my favorite axle. But this is, you have a three different 14 volt castings.
Correct.
These are the two of them. So let's start with this one. What's going on over here?
So this is just the AM 14 volt casting. It is the one of their newer versions. So it's 4-inch. And it's just an OE casting. This is what we originally would build with back before we designed our own.
So if someone's going to the junkyard, if you can find the ribbed, that's the newer one.
Yep.
Rib 14 bolt. If you're looking in the junkyard, you're looking for this. This is a, oh, so this is not your cast. This is an OE cast.
Correct. Yeah.
And so this, let's talk about what makes 14 bolts so cool. So 40 bolts, you know, you've got large ring gear.
Yep.
Removable pinion support.
Yep.
Three bearings on the pinion.
Yeah.
Assembling them is super easy.
Yep. So yeah, it's, you know, got the third pinion bearing. So that obviously gives you the support from deflection on the pinion. And it is nice to be able to pop out that pinion support so you can set your preloads, set everything up, and then you're easily changing shims after that. And then you've got the side adjusters to set backlash. So from a setup perspective, you know, 14 bolts are
really easy.
Yeah.
Nice. Okay. So now, so this is OE and this is one of your upgraded castings. So let's talk about, or forging. Let's talk about this. What do we got right here?
So everybody loves the 14 bolt, like you said, including us. And then came the shave 14 bolt. And one of the downsides to the OE 14 bolt is, you know, the ground clearance. They've got a big lip here that does limit your ground clearance. So you've got shave covers, you've got full shave kits. The full shave kit, you know, involves you shaving the bottom of it, welding on a plate. We talked about it off camera. It's hard to get those to seal up. It wants to warp the cover surface, all these things. It's it was a challenge. We were building those and we're hating life because it was so much work. And so we're like, all right, we got to do a new casting. And we love the 14 bolt, but what do we not love about the 14 bolt? How do we make it better? So we redesigned the whole bottom profile. We tucked it up, and this one is our semi-shaved, so it still takes the full ring gear. Perfectly flat diff cover surface. We've got nice thick material down here at the bottom, but yet we've raised it up. And we took a quick measurement on this one. It was the bottom of the OE casting is 3-inch, and this one is 4 3/8. So 1 3/8 clearance difference. Now, granted, you can grind the bottom of your OE casting.
A little, yeah, because you can get rid of that rib down
there. Sure, yeah. So you're going to pick up some more.
Yeah.
So how much savings is it? I would say 3/4 is a safe estimate on how much ground clearance do you actually get with this casting over a ground OE.
Yeah, but this, and this is, you're not just buying this center because of the extra ground clearance. There's other things about this.
Correct. So the other thing that we all always noticed was the trusses. You know, everybody's building a 14 bolt, putting in a buggy or whatever. You're putting this truss on it. A lot of them are, the truss ends up getting welded to the casting, even though you're tied into the tube. And that truss will flex over time. It'll crack all your welds across, you know, the casting. So we put bosses in here and here so that you can actually bolt the truss to it. Or you can just bolt little plates in here. And then when you put your truss on, you have some tie-in locations to keep that from flexing. Plus, then that ties tube to center casting even more.
Yeah, and it's like you said, that bolt-in gives it the anchor, and then you just weld it in place, and you're good. And then also, I see, is this for an air locker?
Yeah, so most of our castings, not all of them, so I don't want to say that, but you know, when we're designing these castings, it's like, well, during assembly, what's taking us so long? It's like, well, we're always drilling and tapping a hole for an ARB. And in the 14 bolt, particularly, finding that perfect spot isn't the easiest. So we went ahead and pre-drilled, pre-tapped for the ARB. If you're running a spool, you just put an 1/8-inch plug in it and, you know, you're done. But that work's already done for you. You know, we've tapped for the vent already. So, yeah.
Now, this is, you said this is the part shave, so still runs a full ring gear.
Yeah,
which is like we talked before, it's nice because then if you do have a problem, you don't. But if someone wants, if someone's fighting for every inch, you offer this with even more shave, right?
Correct. Yeah, if you want to get a shave gear, then you run our full shave casting, and we'll take even more off the bottom. But we don't do any internal machining.
Okay.
So we internally machine this casting for the full ring gear, and leave the bottom as that raw cast. So in the full shave, we don't machine inside, but we machine the bottom of it to pick up that extra quarter inch.
Get a little bit more out of the bottom. And that still leaves enough beef in there.
Correct.
Because you got that smaller ring here.
Yeah, so partial shave or full shave has the exact same material between ring gear
and the rock.
Yeah. Well, ring gear and the casting, and then casting and rock. So this was my pet rock that everybody's making fun of. But there's your visual difference. You're going to hit the rock, and here you will not hit the rock. You'll just drive right over it. And again, this is the partial shave. So with the full shave, there's even,
more clearance.
Another quarter inch. So, you know, what I do caution people on the full shave is the full shave is a buggy axle. You know, when you do take that OD surface off of a ring gear, that takes away from its letting it release its heat, right? Because there's less surface area. It also does impact the oiling. So, you know, we do want to understand when you're ordering a 14 bolt axle, like, what are you using it for? And if you intend to drive on the street and put miles on your vehicle, because this is a driver as well as a wheeler, you know, do the semi-shave. So it's got the full ring gear. It'll dissipate heat better. It oils better. You've got an easier ring gear to replace too. Because like we talked about off camera, you know, if you do have, you know, a ring gear failure and it's a shave gear, you obviously very specific.
You gotta find that shave.
Yeah, where you got to go to get it. So, you know, by far the semi-shaved is my favorite and very universal. And it's only a quarter inch difference between the two. But if you really need that quarter inch, we have it.
There you go. So factory 14 bolt, semi-shaved 14 bolt, or a full shaved 14 bolt. You can get them all at East Coast Gear Supply.